Good evening, everybody. I'm Dr. Divya Reddy, Senior Resident in the Department of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology at AIIMS BB Nagar, Hyderabad. And today I'd like to present my poster on the topic Saliva-Based Rapid Antigen Tests for SARS-CoV-2 Detection. So basically, for the detection of the SARS-CoV-2 or the coronavirus that causes COVID-19 disease, this is typically done by using upper respiratory tract specimens, that is the nasopharyngeal or the oropharyngeal swabs. But saliva also can be used for detection of this particular virus. This test, as shown in the test kit in figure one, is currently being done in a few developed countries like United States of America, New Zealand, etc. Basically, it's done for screening of asymptomatic cases or mildly symptomatic for rapid detection and isolation before the spread of the virus. But saliva-based tests as of yet have not been approved by the ICMR in India. There is a dire need for these kind of tests, especially in a country like India, where the infectivity rate is very high and so also the burden of the disease. The emergence, especially of the mutant variations, has further crippled the healthcare system in the country. And to curb this infection, there is a requirement of mass screening, especially in densely populated areas or in the so-called red zone regions of the country. And furthermore, as I think some of us have already experienced this, nasopharyngeal sampling technique that is currently being practiced, it is very uncomfortable, invasive, aerosol producing, and usually requires a trained professional to perform the test, as opposed to saliva-based test, which can be performed by the individual themselves, just with mild discomfort. Okay, so coming to the procedure of how it is done, basically the person only has to spit into the tube, which is already pre-filled with a buffer solution, and it's shown in figure A. After that, from figure B to F, it is shown clearly of how what should be done next, that is removal or detachment of the funnel. Then the lid has to be screwed up and the sample has to be mixed with the buffer properly. Then in figure 2, we can see of how the test is being performed. And figure 3 shows us the test result of the rapid antigen test. Of X, that is on the right hand side, it shows negative, and Y shows a positive result. So coming to the precautions that need to be taken before performing the test, that is 30 minutes before performing the test or collecting the sample, no eating, no chewing of gum, no mouthwashes, or no smoking. That is the only precaution that needs to be followed. It is as simple as that. Coming to the research aspect of it, many studies have been conducted on the reliability and the validity of these kind of saliva-based tests. And one such study, which was conducted by Seitz et al. In Austria, where individuals participated in a voluntary mass screening. So based on their findings, it showed that saliva rapid tests basically have a sensitivity of 44%. And their sensitivity increased up to 60% when the viral load was high. That is, the cycle threshold value was very low and the viral load was high. It showed a higher sensitivity. It did not show any variation or no variation in sensitivity was seen in symptomatic cases. And specificity of this test was 100%. Sorel et al., another group, had conducted the study. They had compared the saliva samples with that obtained by the nasopharyngeal samples. And the test was conducted at the point of collection itself. So there was no time delay or gap in the transportation to the nearest laboratory. In this case, he found that the saliva tests were 82% positive percent agreement and 100% negative percent agreement. And just like in other studies, the sensitivity of the saliva tests increased with the increase in viral load. Another test was conducted in India by the Chennai Dental Research Foundation and Voluntary Health Society in collaboration. They had studied about 40 cases, which were proven RT-PCR positive and some were proven RT-PCR negative. And based on that, they checked off how many rapid tests showed the positive result, out of which 56% was the sensitivity and 100 specificity was 100% for saliva-based rapid antigen tests. This is higher than the minimum ICMR guidelines that are set for mass screens. So based on all the findings that we can see, it can be concluded that saliva tests are basically cheaper and safer when compared to nasopharyngeal specimens, which are considered gold standard. And as the oral cavity is one of the major route of transformation, at least in the initial phases, saliva tests can be very beneficial in screening asymptomatic cases or in screening mass cases, mass screenings. And saliva tests are ideal for mass screenings at clinics, especially before we are examining the case, community testing, especially in old age homes, in schools, and it is especially needed in India where there is higher population and limited health resources. So my reference goes as follows in the poster. That's the end of my presentation. Thanks.